We have seen now the rosters for the slam dunk contest and the three-point shootout. We'll get to the three-point contest in just a second for the NBA All-Star game that is taking place in our very city of Los Angeles, California. Ooh. At the Staples Center. Yeah. So the dunk contest is as follows. Aaron Gordon is going to be in it. He's been in it a few years. There's Larry Nance as well from the Los Angeles Lakers.
I like these flyers.
Victor Oladipo of the Indiana Pacers, Bloomington, Indiana University. And Dennis Smith Jr. What exactly are we getting with these four competitors? Take a look and then we'll discuss.
Peyton in that mascot.
Oh! Good change of direction.
Oladipo gonna streak and Smith driving past.
So
this is gonna go back to the 2 points I have about this. I'll go real quick.
Sure.
Remember when whenever there's a big man that's in the dunk contest, it's either an advantage or a disadvantage to what because what they'll look like. You know, when you have a short guy who gets up, it looks amazing because you see this person flying and continuing to elevate, and it actually it gives the appearance
I agree.
Of amazing
it's aesthetically
shit,
pleasing.
Right? Yeah.
Yes.
Larry Nance Jr. What is he? Probably 6'10", but he can leap, right?
6'11".
So that is a disadvantage for the two bigger guys, Gordon and Nance, but. Nance has like it's like a royalty name. Everyone knows Larry Nance was a dunker, his dad. So he's already got the name recognition. It's like a politician, you know?
Yeah, but I don't think the younger generation knows that his dad was in the NBA. Or if they do, I don't think they know
what
even further that his dad
generation?
Was a dunker.
What age is this young generation? Like 13?
25 and under. I don't think so, man. I think you'd be surprised. Like I forgot that he beat Dr. J in the dunk contest. Upon just like being like, oh, Larry Nance is in it. Let me see.
Yeah, you
may have forgotten that he was a dunker. I didn't know that he beat somebody that is great. ABA.
So do they also know who Larry? Not Larry. Do they also know who Dr. J was then? You know, this younger generation.
I think so because you know the Rock the Baby dunks that he had in the dunk contest.
That's the difference. They show it so much. How many throwbacks
especially
of Larry Nance dunks do they show like on a promo?
A few and far between.
Yeah,
few and far between. I agree with you about like the younger, or I'm sorry, the smaller guys having an advantage. It's Aaron Gordon's to lose because we've already seen the creativity that he has. If you are competing with Zach LaVine pre-ACL tear, you're by default my favorite to win it.
Right.
I don't know what Larry Nance can do because he. Or what he will do because he sort of reminds me of JaVale McGee. When JaVale dunked on two separate hoops. Because like they're both tall as shit. They're both super lengthy as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know exactly what Nance is gonna do. Here's my other problem with like Larry Nance and Dennis Smith. They're like dunking over guys. I don't know what they'll do when there is no one trying to impede their way to dunk a basketball.
Yeah, they have to. And the thing is, this is what I've always said. It's like that with music a lot and also with these types of competitions. Everything has generally been done. So you either have to recreate something that was done and put a small change on it. It's hard to innovate something else. And that's what's been happening in recent years with the dunk contest. You got to start jumping over mascots. You got to start pulling a car in. You have to have an assistant, what's it called? One of your teammates come in and toss a ball to you. If you watch an old school dunk contest from the beginning to end, not just the highlights, watch one of Jordan's from like 87
or
something.
Oh, like the Jordan Dominique Wilkins at Chicago Stadium.
Same one happened today, people go, I'm gonna turn this bullshit off, is what they would say. Because, and I'm not saying it was horrible.
Nah.
They did it first, so they were innovating. Now that it's been 35 years.
And that's why you need to be more creative. Think of stuff.
But
we saw
tough.
It with LaVine and Aaron Gordon.
We're still
Why
humans,
can't have it
though.
Again?
They can't start jumping off the roof because they're still humans.
Only if you're Ben Staples.
So it's the hard thing. I'm giving them benefit of the doubt. I'm giving them some leeway because it's hard from this perspective to do something different. If somebody has a free throw dunk one now, they're like, oh yeah, sure, whatever, out of here.
You don't give it a 50.
But Jordan is always gonna be the one for that. Jordan did the free throw dunk. Oh,
so did
my
Brent
God,
Berry.
Amazing. Yeah, Brent Berry did. Who cares now, right? Brent Berry did it. It was still 15 years ago he did it. No one still cares.
He was on the Clippers at the time when he did that?
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah, it's just there's less leeway for innovation.
Just try to think outside the box.
But they've done that. That's when it got ridiculous.
There's still so much more that could possibly be done. that we just haven't seen yet. And maybe we will. Maybe we'll see
NBA Jam type dunks where they're rolling in midair. And you can't do it. It's impossible.
There was one NBA Live game where you could do like three-point contest and slam dunk contest. And there was a dunk where you could put it through your legs twice. And that was like, oh, my God, amazing. Like, yeah, do that.
Go.
Thoughts, comment section below.
Who's your winner, by the way? I'm sorry.
Aaron Gordon.
You think Aaron's winning?
Yours?
I'm going Nance.
Larry Nance?
Yeah.
You want to bet on it?
$5? What if maybe one of us wins?
Chipotle burrito?
Yeah.
Down.